Subscribe the channel and press the bell icon to get latest updates from learnfordafer.com.
Dear students, we know that matter is made up of particles, which can be divided into smaller particles, such that it reaches to smallest indivisible unit called as atom.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on LearnFutafut Android app. Download the app now.
Discovery of atom generated curiosity among the researchers to determine its structure. So they started various experiments to explain its structure. During these experiments, it was revealed that even atoms are further divisible into charged particles. Hence, to know the structure of atom, it became necessary to understand properties of these charged particles. And again, the race began to explore more about these charged particles. In 1886, E. Goldstein discovered new positively charged radiations in a gas discharge tube. He called them as canal rays. This led to the discovery of subatomic particle called proton, denoted by P+. Later in 1900, British scientist J.G. Thomson discovered another subatomic particle with an opposite charge to proton, that is, negatively charged particle called electron.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on LearnFutafut Android app. Download the app now.
Mass of subatomic particles. Mass of proton is 2000 times more than mass of electron. It is taken as one unit with positive charge. Mass of an electron is considered to be negligible with charge -1. After discovery of subatomic particles, researchers came up with assumptions like atom contains same number of protons and electrons. Protons are present in the interior of atom. Electrons can be removed from atom. Likewise, different scientists proposed different atomic models. Let's take a look on activity which will demonstrate that atom is made up of subatomic particles.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on LearnFutafut Android app. Download the app now. Subscribe the channel and press the bell icon to get latest updates from LearnFutafut.com.
Thomson's model of atom. The model shows similarity with the structure of watermelon, where sphere of watermelon is considered to be an atom.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on LearnFutafut Android app. Download the app now.
Red part of watermelon is taken as positive charge spread over entire surface, whereas electrons are embedded into the positive charge, just like the seeds of watermelon in the red part. This model is also known as plum pudding model. Further, this model states that the positive and negative charge are in same quantity and are evenly distributed in entire atomic space. Therefore, an atom is electrically neutral, that is, total charge is zero. Rutherford's model. Ernest Rutherford carried out an experiment in which he bombarded alpha particles, that is, helium ions, on a gold foil of small thickness. He observed that most of the alpha particles passed through gold foil. Some alpha particles got deflected by small angles. Very few, say 1 out of 12,000 particles were reflected back on same path.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on Learn Fatafat Android app. Download the app now.
On the basis of these observations, Rutherford concluded that most alpha particles passed without deflection, so there must be large empty space inside the atom. Few alpha particles get deflected, so there must be some strong and dense opposition inside the atom, due to which this happens. The opposition must be having positive charge, as the positively charged alpha particles were deflected. Very few particles are reflected back. This shown that positive charge and most of the mass of atom were present in small volume within an atom. With his experiments, Rutherford was able to identify that radius of dense space is about 10 raised to 5 times smaller than size of atoms. So with this information, he put forth nuclear model of an atom, according to which a positively charged dense mass situated at the center of atom is called as nucleus. Size of nucleus is very small with respect to size of atom. Electrons revolve around nucleus in circular path.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on Learn Fatafat Android app. Download the app now.
Drawbacks of Rutherford's model. Dear students, atoms in a matter are stable. According to Rutherford's model, electrons revolve around the nucleus in a circular path. Charged electron in motion have acceleration. Hence, it radiates energy constantly in the form of waves. While revolving, electrons must be losing energy continuously. Due to the loss of energy, radius or revolution must be decreasing. And finally, electrons should fall into the nucleus, suggesting that atom is unstable. However, this does not happen. Rutherford's model failed to explain the reason behind it.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on Learn Fatafat Android app. Download the app now.
Rutherford's model failed to explain atom stability. Niels Bohr made modification in Rutherford's model and presented an advanced version of atomic model. Bohr compared structure of atoms with planetary motion. As the planets revolve around the sun, electrons revolve around the nucleus.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on Learn Fatafat Android app. Download the app now.
So, according to Bohr's theory, electrons revolve in circular paths called as orbits or energy shells or energy levels. There is possibility of infinite orbits in an atom. However, in very few discrete, that is, distinct orbits, electrons have stable energies. Therefore, only stable orbits are allowed in an atom. Energy of an electron may undergo change only if electron jump from one orbit to another. If electron gain energy, it will jump to higher orbit, or if it loses energy, then it will jump to lower level. Orbits or shells are represented by alphabets K, L, M, N, or also by numbers N equals to 1, 2, 3, 4. Before continuing with this, it is important to know the discovery of neutron.
Thank you. watch ad-free and complete syllabus on Learn Fatafat Android app. Download the app now.
Around 1920s, it was believed that atom is composed of protons and electrons. In 1932, James Chadwick discovered another subatomic particle while experimenting in Cavendish Laboratory. This particle was named as neutron. Neutrons have mass similar to that of proton. Nucleus of atoms contains neutrons along with protons. Together these are called as nucleons. Neutrons are represented by small n. The mass of atom is given as sum of protons and neutrons present in the nucleus. In 1935, Chadwick was honored with Nobel Prize in Physics for discovery of neutrons.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on Learn Fatafat Android app. Download the app now.
Dear students, atom is composed of protons, neutrons, and electrons, where electrons are present in the shell of an atom. Now, major challenge before the scientist was to know how electrons were distributed in the shell of an atom.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on Learn Fatafat Android app. Download the app now.
Bohr and Perry in 1921 presented some rules to show distribution of electrons in shell of atom. Number of electrons in a single orbit are calculated by formula 2n square, where n is shell number or energy level. K shell is first shell. Here n equals to 1. Therefore, K shell will have, which is equals to 2 electrons. Similarly, L shell will have 2 into 2 raised to 2, which is equals to 2 into 4, which is equals to 8 electrons. In this way, electrons from different energy levels are easily known. Normally, we use the terms duplet if orbit allows only 2 electrons. Similarly, we use the term octet if orbit allows 8 electrons to be filled in it. Electron starts filling from inner shell towards outermost shells. Atomic structure of few elements are given below. Let's now understand about the term valency. It is clear that every atom tend to achieve octet in its outermost shells. Atom do this by either of the three ways: by donating electron to another atom, or by accepting electron from another atom, or by sharing of its electrons with other atom. So we can define valency as the combining capacity of the atom.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on Learn Fatafat Android app. Download the app now.
It is the number of electrons in outermost shell, or 8 minus electrons in outermost shell. Let's take an example of sodium and chlorine. Sodium has 1 electron in outermost shell and chlorine has 7 electrons in outermost shell. For sodium, it is very easy to lose 1 electron rather than accepting 7 more electrons to gain stability. Hence, valency of sodium is 1 and not 7. For chlorine, it is easy to accept 1 electron rather than losing 7 electrons. Hence, valency of chlorine is 1 and not 7.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on Learn Fatafat Android app. Download the app now.
Elements like helium, neon, argon have 8 electrons in their outermost shell. That is, they have stable octet. Hence, valency of such elements is 0.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on Learn Fatafat Android app. Download the app now.
Dear students, in this video, we are going to learn some important terminologies related to atom. First, we will learn atomic number. It is the number of protons present in nucleus of an atom, denoted by capital Z.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on Learn Fatafat Android app. Download the app now.
Example, sodium has 11 protons in its nucleus. Hence, atomic number of sodium is 11. Atoms of same element have same atomic number. Example, all atoms of sodium will have atomic number 11. Atomic number of all chemical elements is unique, which is used to identify that element. For example, only sodium will have atomic number 11, and hence, atomic number 11 defines sodium element. Atomic number of some elements are shown in the table. Mass number. Nucleus of an atom contains protons and neutrons, collectively called as nucleons.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on Learn Fatafat Android app. Download the app now.
As mass of electron is negligible, then mass of atom depends on masses of protons and neutrons. So, mass number is defined as sum of total number of protons and neutrons present in nucleus of an atom and is denoted by capital A. Example, sodium has 11 protons and 12 neutrons. Hence, mass number of sodium is 23. For an atom, atomic number and mass number is denoted symbolically as XZA. Following are few elements with their mass number and symbols. Isotopes. Dear students, in nature, there exist two or more forms of same element known as isotopes. Isotopes are chemically same but physically different from each other. This difference occurs due to change in number of neutrons present in an atom of that element. Hence, isotopes can be defined as atom of same element having same atomic number but different mass number. For example, carbon has isotopes C6-12 and C6-14.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on Learn Fatafat Android app. Download the app now.
It can be easily seen that mass number of isotopes are different, whereas they have same atomic number. So, if you take an amount of element, isotopes of that element will be present in an appropriate ratio. In case of chlorine, Cl1735 and Cl1737, they occur in the ratio of 3:1. Hence, average atomic mass can be calculated as 35 into 75 upon 100 plus 37 into 25 upon 100, which is equals to 105 by 4 plus 37 by 4, which is equals to 142 by 4, which is equals to 35.5 unit. 35.5 shows average atomic mass of Cl1735 and Cl1737. Following are some isotopes and their uses. Isobars. If atoms of different elements contain same number of nucleons in the nucleus, then they are considered as isobars. Isobars can be defined as elements having same mass number but different atomic number. Some examples of isobars are, so dear students, I hope you understood these terms very well. Stay connected for more videos.
Like, share and subscribe learnphotaphot.com and press the bell icon to never miss an updates from learnphotaphot.com.